Okay, so now we replace to Android device, and we will do a test for this. So the remote control already connected. And also we replace another battery. So now the aircraft is already connected. So you can check on the wireless setting, and now it comes with 2.4G, and you can choose to 5G, and you just simply select the channel. So we will check on this. So now it's 5G and ready to take off. So we record.
The whole point is take off.
So now it's 500 meter. We try climb to a 200 meter altitude as same as a previous one. So now it's 1002. And the signal, now the signal is keep on and off. So signal lost on and off. So 1006. We try push up some more. Maybe we go up to 250. So now 250 altitude, and now we have a 2000 range, and still ongoing 2001. So now 2003, and disconnected. So about 2003. So we are waiting the aircraft returning home. By the way, actually I need to test on this Samsung Galaxy Note 8, but unfortunately that wireless connection between this SE version and my phone is keep disconnected. I cannot run that DJI Go, so I do send a report to this DJI support, and I hope the engineer can fix this problem, because now we have a lot of new devices launching coming out, like a 10 the iPhone 8 and iPhone 10, so and other Android devices. They all come with a latest version, like above version 7 or version 7.1 something. So DJI engineer, he have to work out on this software, because otherwise we cannot use. Even though the devices is very expensive, but it still cannot connect to the DJI Go apps. This is a no point for us to use it. So it's almost returned back to the home. Because now it's testing on this 5.8 Wi-Fi signal, and we will do one more for this 2.4 Wi-Fi signal and see got any different or not. And now getting hot already. So the bad boy is coming back now.
Landing.
So the position landing is a bit far.